Hello bishez, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I figured I'd just do something a little bit different and show a little bit of how I work on a current comic page for my graphic novel, because today I wanted to talk about how to publish your first comic book, but I wanted to talk about it through the lens of someone who is still very much going through the process. I still have not finished publishing my graphic novel yet, but I feel like you get a more real perspective from someone who is still going through the process instead of me just finishing my graphic novel already and have it already out in the bookstores and be like, yeah, it was a great experience. But I feel like when I talk about it while I'm still going through it, you can get a more realistic perspective. But before I get too deep into today's video, I first wanted to thank Clip Studio Paint for sponsoring today's video. So for any of you who are not familiar with Clip Studio Paint, it is basically a digital art program that provides a lot of useful and unique features for your very specific art making needs. So for example, if you are a comic artist, there are so many assets within Clip Studio Paint that just make the workflow so much more streamlined and easier for you. They provide a lot of assets for your comic making needs, and whether if you're a comic artist or an illustrator, there are so many other different assets and functions that can really be useful for that specific art making process. So for any of you who are trying to make your own comics right now and you're still in the middle of debating what is the best art program for you to use, well, definitely consider Clip Studio Paint, because again, they have a lot of options for comic artists, and I can definitely say for me, it has made my workflow a lot easier. So getting back into the world of publishing, you might be wondering, why publish a comic book? And for some of us, it's as easy as, you know, you've read comics when you were little, you read manga and you were inspired, and you just wanted to make your own comic and story ever since then. And that's great. For some other artists, it might be a little bit more complicated, because making a comic book definitely is a huge commitment that you're not sure if you want to do just yet. But for example, working in animation, it is getting harder and harder to really have your voice out there and run your own show, because nowadays a lot of studios are looking for IP work, or work that's pretty much already been created and tried and tested and shown to people, and you know, people are getting more afraid to take risks, honestly. So when they see a project that has already been created, the story has already been told, and there's already an audience out there for it, they're more likely to want to take a chance on it. So I'm just personally speaking from my observations as an artist in animation in 2021. So if you're watching this in like 2030 or 2050, this could be totally irrelevant by then. But yeah, other reasons why artists might be wanting to publish their own graphic novel could be simply as another form of income, because the publishing world is kind of a little bit more flexible with schedules, and you might still want to have a project that you claim as your own outside of your day job, as well as having that other source of income to help you with your living situation or daily needs. So having a comic book can kind of be useful for artists for basically many reasons. So first and foremost, before you publish your first comic book, you might be wondering what it is that you need. And first, you will need to have an idea, and that will consist of what type of story do you want to tell and what type of art style best suits that story. Because when you go to a bookstore, you will notice that there's now a huge range of different types of graphic novels and comics. There are monochromatic comics, there are fully colored comics, and now they can range from ages kids to adults. So your options for publishing comics can be a little bit overwhelming. However, if you do want full autonomy over your comic book and you want 100% creative control and say into your work, maybe self-publishing might be more up your alley. But if you do want to publish with a publisher, there slightly might be more limitations to it. And I'm not saying that you lose total creative control if you work with a publisher, because I will say that you do still have creative control. However, when it comes to a target audience, you're going to make stories that are more targeted towards a specific audience, because when it comes to pitching your story or idea to an agent or a publisher, you're going to have to let people know what is your target audience. And it could be middle school aged girls, or it could be full grown adult males, or whatever. And whatever your target audience is, you're going to be telling a story that will somewhat resonate with that audience. And you can still kind of tell whatever story you want within that target audience realm. However, that's the thing, is that you're just going to have to keep this target audience in mind. For some people, that could be very limiting, but for other people, it might be like, hey, thanks for narrowing down my choices. And usually I would say the best target audience is for somebody that is either around your age, because you understand what it is to be going through something at your age right now, or for someone maybe a little bit younger than you, because you've already went through that life stage in your life to know what to talk about. But of course you can still be making stories for people outside of your target audience. However, you will kind of need to have a better understanding of what they're looking for when they are reading comics. And then when it comes to your art style, preferably it should be something that will resonate with your target audience. And if it's something that is already in the realm of who you're targeting for, then great. Maybe you don't need to change your art style. However, for example, for me, if I wanted to make a story catered towards a male audience, I don't think that my current cute style will really be doing well with that population. So I might have to shift my art style to be more catered towards the male audience if I wanted to tell a story that was more for middle-aged males or something like that. But also, why would I want to do that when I'm really more catered towards telling female stories? So think about that before you create your own story. But also, again, if you don't want to be working with this target audience situation, maybe self-publishing is more up your alley. Then next is developing a pitch to sell your idea to agents and publishers. So I would recommend that you look for an agent before you go to a publisher, because an agent is kind of like the middleman or middlewoman who will really be able to understand the publishing world and make sure that you have your rights protected as an author and artist, because not all artists are immediately familiar with the publishing world. I for sure was not familiar with the publishing world, so having an agent really helped me understand what publishers are looking for and how I can really develop something that could be potentially accepted by a publisher. And they also definitely helped me with protecting my rights and making sure that I get the correct amount of pay I should be getting for whatever work I'm putting into my stuff. So when you're developing a pitch, of course, you have to include your target audience, give a summary of your story, who you are, and just all the background stuff. And when it comes to finding an agent, it's going to be a little bit difficult to just find an agent just out of the blue, out of nowhere. So definitely Google agencies for publishing, and within those agencies, there are different agents that might be willing to work with you. So Google different agents, or even find a community of comic artists who are familiar with agents within that graphic novel industry, and they can give you some recommendations. So a lot of Instagram artists might even have agents that they have ready to recommend to you, so don't be afraid to reach out to comic artists online within your community if you are looking for an agent. So after you develop your pitch, you're going to pretty much email the pitch to these agents and see if anyone is willing to work with you. And then after you got your agent, great. Now it's time to find a publisher. So this could either work both ways, where either a publisher finds you or you find the publisher. And maybe you might already have a publisher in mind, because when you're reading comic books as a youngin, you might have already seen publishing companies that you're like, hey, I really like the line of comics that have been coming out of this publishing company. I would like to work with them in the future. So maybe you already have an ideal one in mind, and you and your agent can put a package together to pitch to that company. Or another situation might be like, you're already posting your art on Instagram, you're posting your comics on Webtoons or some sort of platform, and then a company reaches out to you. So if you're already sharing your artwork or comics online on Instagram or some other platform and a publisher reaches out to you, that honestly might make it a little bit easier because a publisher is already somewhat familiar with your work and you don't have to really go out and search for one yourself. But that is just the benefit of sharing your work online, but that is not everybody's cup of tea. However, that's just one of the benefits is you will be more easily discoverable by publishers if you do choose to do so. I wanted to take a moment to talk about what I'm doing right now in Clip Studio Paint. So I'm using their manga panels feature. So they have these default assets of all these different types of panel structures for comics readily available for you to use. So for any of you who don't want to make your own panels, there's already panels ready for you to just drag and drop. But you can also adjust these panels to your liking. So you can adjust panels that might be similar to the structure you were imagining. But for me personally, I like to have some customization. So I literally just drag and dropped a custom manga panel structure and I just customized it to my own liking. And then I would trace over the panels with my own line work because I personally kind of like the more natural hand feeling, but at least I have the structure already planned out for me to just easily trace over. And they also have these speech bubbles that you can literally also just drag and drop for any of you who don't want to make your own speech bubbles. But again, I just personally like to trace things over to just give it that more natural vibe. So you do you, whatever is up your alley, but again, it just makes life a little bit easier. Speaking of digital art programs, that is actually something you're going to have to decide on because after you pitched your story idea, your book idea to your agent and publisher, and after you all settle on an agreement, then the bookmaking process becomes real. And the reason why the digital art program is going to sort of matter is because you're not the only one who's going to be touching the pages of your graphic novel. You might have a little team at the publishing company you're working with, and somebody else is going to eventually be going into your graphics as well, either adding text, or you might have a colorist working with you because a lot of graphic novel artists also have a colorist working by their side, helping them color in their pages. So the program that you're using might be important to know for the other people so that whatever you're working with on your file translates to the other program that other people are using. So knowing that you are all using the same digital art program is going to help a lot. And nowadays, I see Clip Studio Paint being accepted everywhere from animation studios to publishing companies used as a form of a digital art program. So just to step back a little bit to give an overview of what is happening when you're publishing your book now. So first, you're developing a pitch that you will pitch to an agent, and hopefully you land on a very good agent who is willing to work with you. And just so you're aware, an agent does take a commission from the payments that you get from your publishing company. But assuming that this is a good and the right agent, usually it will be worth it because your agent is usually the one who is, again, protecting your rights as an author and artist, and they are also negotiating the most fair and best deal for you from the publishing company, so you're probably still going to make more money when you work with an agent than if you went to a publishing company yourself, completely clueless about how the publishing world works. So after you find an agent and they agree to work on your pitch with you to pitch to other publishing companies, you will then go to different publishing companies with your agent, and by going, I mean just emailing them and pitching your book idea to them, and you will go with the one that is either offering you the best deal or the one that accepts you, because if only one accepts you and you really want to publish your book, then you'll probably just go with them. But of course, know that if you're going with this publishing company, make sure all your rights as an author, artist is protected, and again, that's what your agent is there to help you with understanding. So after you agree with this publisher, that's when you will sign a contract together. And this is the part where the agent really understands what is behind each line in the contract, and you can ask your agent all of these questions and they will help answer them for you so you understand what it is you're signing up for. And afterwards, through that contract, you're establishing milestone payments. So I'm not sure if this is for every single publishing company out there, but from what I'm aware of, a lot of publishing companies tend to just pay you through every milestone that you achieve. So let's say you got the rough draft done, cool. You get your payment once that's accepted. After you get your rough draft done, let's say you get the final art done, then you get the next payment done. And cool, that's when you get your payment. So it's not like a regular job where you're getting paid every week. It's more so anytime you get this big step of the book done and it is accepted by the publishing company, there you go, it is payday. And of course, be aware that this will go through your agency most likely, because they're the ones who are taking a commission of what you make. But again, it is worth it if you have a good agent. And then next, you're going to be going back and forth between editing drafts with the editor. This is kind of the most time-consuming process because you're working through the story 10 million different times, trying to make it better each time. So every time you go through your notes, make sure that you kind of completed as many notes as you possibly can, because if your editor is really busy, they might take a long time to respond back to you. And just be aware that you're going to be playing the waiting game a lot for when you're hearing back for feedback for your book. But in the meantime, other things that you can think about are colorists. So this is something that you'll have to make aware of before you pitch your book idea, because that will be a part of the contract and negotiations is the colorist. So if you know that you're someone who will need help with coloring, definitely let your agent and publisher know beforehand, and they will help you go out and look for one. So for the coloring that I'm doing right now in Clip Studio Paint, though, this is not the actual coloring for my final graphic novel. This is just me just doing whatever I want for the sake of this comic page, just to show you all an example of just a completed comic page. And again, Clip Studio Paint has brushes and screen tones that you can use for your comics. So now you might be wondering, well, what do I do now that I finished my comic book? Like, does it just go out to people or what? And for me personally, I haven't even gotten to this stage yet myself either. I'm currently in the stage right before that where I'm kind of in the middle of final art. So from what I've heard and what I've been told is that there will be a brief period of time where your book will just be marketed towards people to just gauge their attention and just awareness that your book will be coming out soon. So during this time period, publishing companies are most likely going to be leveraging their social media platforms and email newsletters to let people know that your book is coming out soon. And during this time, I think that you should also leverage your own social media platform to let your supporters know that your book is coming out. And as much as a publishing company can, you know, let people from around the world know that your book is coming out, I feel like there is no better audience member than the people that have been following you and supporting you for a long time. So I don't know, if you're someone who's not really into using social media, like, to each their own, but I think that if you do want to boost the number of sales and increase your opportunities for publishing more in the future, definitely try to leverage your own social media platform so that you feel like you have some sort of control as well when it comes to marketing your book. And then after all that is when, like, the royalties and the payments and you making appearances at, like, random bookstores happen, but that is definitely still far in the future for me, so I will save that in another video to talk about for whenever I get to that stage, because that's another layer of complexity that comes much after publishing your book. But for now, this is pretty much what I understand so far from publishing your first comic book. So yeah, anyway, I hope this video helped some of you out there who are in the middle of possibly considering whether or not if you want to publish a graphic novel, and maybe this could be the seed of inspiration for you to be like, oh yeah, maybe I do want to publish a graphic novel, or no, I don't want to publish a graphic novel. Either way, I hope this video helped you make some sort of decision, and thank you again so much to Clip Studio Paint for sponsoring today's video. Definitely check out Clip Studio Paint if you are considering a digital art program, whether it be for comic making or just making art in general. They definitely have a lot of unique features that could be of some use to you. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. So peace out and stay wholesome, bishez.